The one area that I think affiliates could benefit most in terms of finances from having a greater understanding of would be our tax system in this country and how it works and how they can leverage that to their advantage in growing their business. And specifically what we're talking about is the reinvestment of profits. Rick, what does reinvestment mean and how do you utilize that at Alamo?
I guess to put it simply, it might mean we get to bonus our trainers. It might mean we're going to order a big old equipment order from, you know, said equipment companies. Reinvestment means making the experience for our members better. It means making our place better. It could mean an investment in the community. You know, we participate in fundraising events, and some of that reinvestment dollars might go into simply giving it to a charity. So, reinvestment, it could be pretty. I'm sure there's a definite example, but that this. Could be a lot of different things.
Well, let's segue into a definite example. The idea of how reinvesting in your business. First, what is the aim? And second, how does it minimize your tax burden? The aim is always to increase that top line. The increase is in the short term or in the long term, and we always tend to have a long term bias. Let's increase revenue, right? Let's knock down a wall and rent more space. That's a reinvestment. Let's buy another barbell. That's a reinvestment. Let's hire another trainer. That's a reinvestment. What I'm doing is I'm increasing my expense line with the idea that spending that money is eventually going to get me more clients and increase my revenue line. But here's what happens. When you spend that money, instead of your profit being high, your profit gets lower, right? You have revenue minus expenses equals profit. When I increase my expenses in the near term, my profit drops. The United States government taxes you on your profit. That is however much you have left at the end of the day. And so if you're minimizing that profit by putting things in the expense line that will in fact increase your revenue long term, what you're doing is you're minimizing your tax burden. And by minimizing your tax burden, you're setting yourself up not necessarily for more revenue now, not more revenue tomorrow, but perhaps more revenue 3 months from now, 4 months from now. And so what we want to do is understand that you get a discount on everything you buy for your business. And you get that discount at a rate that's equal to what's called your marginal tax rate. And so if at the end of the year you made $100, and let's say that the marginal tax rate on that is 33%, what that means is you'd pay $33 in taxes. But if you spent $50 more and your profit was only $50, instead of your tax burden being $33, it would be $16.50. So essentially, you went from $33 in taxes to $16.50 in taxes. You saved $16.50. Ergo, you can think of it as I saved $16.50 on that $50 purchase. I saved 33%. And in that manner, in that basic understanding, we want to think, am I setting myself up for future growth? Jay, you kind of alluded to this. You said you wanted your bottom line at the end of the year to be what?
Zero.
I want my profit to be zero. Now, I don't go quite that far, right? Because you might want to borrow money, you might want to show the bank that you're turning a profit and so on and so forth. But by having it zero, you're still setting your business up to make money the next year, right? And with every passing year, you want it to be better, more able to make more money. And that's kind of the essence of reinvestment. That said, and I know this is a very personal question, but the answers are very different. And this is one that the business owner often struggles with. How much should I pay myself? And you need to know that under different business forms, you may or may not be able to pay yourself. For instance, if you are an LLC, a limited liability company in this country, you can't draw a paycheck. It's actually against IRS regulations. But if you're a corporation, you certainly can. And feel free to tell me to go screw. But Jay, how much do you pay yourself?
It depends on the month and how well we're doing. I'd rather not say on camera exactly what I pay myself, but I try to keep it within reason of what our coaches are being paid, our full-time coaches.
So just like 20 or 30 times more, and then
yeah,
just keep it in the range.
I won't pay myself more than 20 times what our full-time coaches make, but they get paid well.
And Ben, you don't pay yourself.
No, I don't pay myself a salary.
Okay, no. And why not?
We're an LLC. So I draw directly out of the profit of the company.
Right, and so you draw out of retained earnings. Yeah. How about you, Rick? What's your situation there?
I do not. We're an LLC also. I do not take a salary or a draw currently from the gym. I choose to, our coaches are paid, their salaries and their monies, and everything else is reinvested, so.
And I think, you know, the line of questioning is a little bit uncomfortable, so I'll stop here. But understand that every dime that you do take out, whether as a draw or as salary from your company, is money that you can't do what with? You can't reinvest it, right? And Amy, you, when we started this, you know, I've been poor my whole life. You said, you know, to start this thing, we had no nice cars. We had roommates that, you know, maybe we loved and maybe we didn't. And that you continued down that path. Why?
Just so you have more money to put back into the business, which is gonna make it better. I mean, just everything that we've, you know, pretty much, I mean, what happened with us is that we invested a lot of money into our first business, but we made it all back within 6 months. So then we just put it into this space. And so, you know, and now, and that, you know, we saw such a big boom in growth as soon as we opened the second gym, even though we're still the same business, we're in the same location, but people were so spread out that they just, you know, got more attention and, you know, people were more attracted to the space because there's, you know, more going on. And so it was a real benefit for us.
And so when we talk about reinvesting in your business, this isn't a euphemistic term. This isn't a metaphor for anything. In fact, Rick, one of the things that you put in your answers was that, hey, I could invest this money elsewhere. I could put it in an IRA, which is simply a retirement vehicle, and I could earn 6-7% annually in compounded returns on that. Or, quote unquote, I could invest in me in this business and earn ungodly returns. What's the difference in your mind between putting your money in the stock market and reinvesting in your business? Because you clearly have the option.
The difference is what we are. We're entrepreneurs. We choose to invest in ourselves and our abilities, our dreams, our goals, desires, our wants, and the commitment and what we want to do as opposed to what is safe. That's the way I explain it. Because I'm a nurse. I could easily have a career for 25 years as a nurse and be safe and retire with a nice 401k, but we choose not to. I choose to take those monies and reinvest back into the business, into the gym, and again, the returns are, they're as high as you can imagine. They can be as high or as much as you can imagine, and it's beyond 6-7% compounded annually.
I'm sure that you haven't calculated what's called your return on invested capital, but if you've taken $100,000 plus, socked into this business, and paid yourself back in 6 months, what you've done is doubled your money. In 6 months. That doesn't happen in the stock market, it doesn't happen in your IRA, it doesn't happen in your 401k, but it came with a tremendous amount of what? It came with a tremendous amount of
work and sacrifice.
And risk. Right?
Yeah.
And risk some people aren't willing to take. And risk and return always march hand in hand.